Summer is on its way, and that means more sun, more heat, and unfortunately, more ticks. Gross. Hey everyone, Julia here for DNews. Lyme disease is weird, mysterious, and can be pretty stubborn. Every tick season, 300,000 Americans will become infected, according to the US Centers for Disease Control. The symptoms are similar to a flu, like fever and aches, so a lot of cases go untreated. Only 30,000 cases get reported each year, but other symptoms can get worse, much worse, like chronic and debilitating joint pain. You can get Lyme disease from the bite of a black-legged deer tick, but not all ticks carry the disease. According to Paul Mead, Chief of Epidemiology and Surveillance Activity at the CDC, one out of every four or five ticks might be infected in areas where the disease is very common. There are a lot of misconceptions about Lyme disease. Some people think that everyone who gets the disease will get a telltale bullseye redness around the tick bite, but that's not always the case. The CDC says around 70% of people get the mark, but it can vary by region. But Lyme disease doesn't vary too much. It's been reported in every state except Hawaii. The disease is caused by the bacteria Borrelia burgdorferi. The bacteria is old, like really old. Researchers from Ohio State University found ticks infected with it trapped in amber in the Dominican Republic. In a study published in the journal Historical Biology, they found they could be around 15 to 20 million years old. Basically, as long as people have been getting bit by ticks, there's been Lyme disease. You know that famous ice mummy, Ötzi? Yeah, he might have had Lyme disease. In analyzing his genome, scientists found fragments of the bacteria's genetic material. At 5,300 years old, that could be the oldest case ever found of the disease. Ötzi, like others, would have suffered from some of the nasty symptoms like pain. Most of the symptoms are caused by the way the disease targets the immune system. It triggers inflammation and can attack the peripheral nervous system, causing pain spreading from the back to the arms and legs and hands and feet. One study published in the American Journal of Pathology found that this inflammation can also affect the central nervous system, causing headaches and fatigue, and even scary symptoms like memory loss, learning disability, or depression. Lyme disease can be cured if it's caught early, but it's often misdiagnosed as something else. So sometimes these symptoms persist, becoming chronic and debilitating in about 10 to 20% of patients. It's estimated that about a million Americans live with what's called post-treatment Lyme disease. A recent study published in Antimicrobial Agents and Chemotherapy found why it's just so hard to get rid of. Even though Lyme disease is caused by bacteria, antibiotics often don't work to treat the pathogen. So the bacteria forms what's called dormant persister cells, which evade antibiotics. And just like their name suggests, these guys aren't killed by antibiotics, they lie dormant. Then they might wake up after a round of treatment and wreak havoc on the nervous system. But the researchers also identified two potential treatments for PTLD. One is a treatment for cancer called Mitomycin C, which wiped out all cultures of the bacteria. But the treatment is pretty toxic, so it's probably not the best way to go. Another way involves multiple doses of antibiotics. In what's called pulse dosing, the researchers repeatedly dosed the bacteria. In the first round, some cells died, but those dormant persister cells didn't. They woke up and tried to re-establish a population. But before they did, researchers hit them with another round of antibiotics. After four rounds of treatment, the bacteria were all eradicated. But this was only in a test tube, so more research is needed. If you're worried about Lyme disease and tick bites, the CDC recommends knowing where deer ticks are commonly found, wearing protective clothing and insect repellent if you go into those areas, and to do daily checks of your body if you've been outside, even in your own backyard. If a tick is attached to your body for less than 24 hours, your chances of getting the disease are small. Speaking of tiny things that could potentially harm you, have you ever wondered what the heck a virus is? I've got the short and sweet answer for you in this episode of my new show, Test Tube 101. Check it out and subscribe.
They have DNA or RNA, but they're not made up of cells like other life forms. They do reproduce, but they need a host cell to do it. In short, they're weird.
Have you ever been bitten by a tick or had Lyme disease? Tell us your story down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here to DNews. We've got new episodes every day of the week.